My name is Stuart Scott, and I'm here at COP21 in Paris, France, and I run the Climate Matters TV show. I use the facilities that the UN provides to all NGOs, but I use them in a creative way, and I've created Climate Matters TV.
Thanks very much, Stuart.
Dr. Hansen joined us for the second Climate Matters show of COP21. The audience was packed.
I would like to talk about climate justice and governmental honesty.
He gave a very effective message that the goals the COP is working towards are false goals. They're offering false solutions.
All the ministers are coming here, or the heads of state, and they're planning to clap each other on the back and say, oh, we're really doing great. This is a very successful conference. We're going to address the climate problem. Well, if that's what happens, then we're screwing the next generation and the following ones.
The New York Times printed an article online within 2 hours of the press conference. It was a major coup to get James Hansen's minority report into the mainstream media in that loud a fashion. It raised a lot of eyebrows, I am sure. There was probably a lot of consternation in high offices in government, but we got it out there. I came to COP14 in Poznan, Poland. That was my first COP. I literally quit my day job and decided to devote what should have been my retirement to trying to figure out how to address this huge problem I saw coming at us, climate change. The people who I'm seeing turn up now are an order of magnitude stronger in terms of being the real players, the power brokers. Governor of the Bank of England, Mark Carney, attended. Now, I spent the better part of this year trying to get him to come to the COP. I have no idea whether they worked or not, those messages. But I went up on stage yesterday and shook his hand and said, Mr. Carney, thanks for coming. So the fact that the head of the Bank of England came to talk about climate change, it's extraordinary. I'm credited by the UN with having introduced the interfaith community into the negotiations. There were individual religious organizations who were attending, but they had not coalesced. And I had an epiphany during the year 2009, and I staged the interfaith declaration on climate change, and I was told, that's good stuff, please keep doing it. This is a battle between forces of money and economics and forces of ecology and environment. The stakes are survival of life on Earth, ultimately, but in the nearer term, the potential collapse of civilization.